It took 30 years, but now, for the first time after being kidnapped and tortured, Jewish banker Eduardo Sayé feels he's closer to justice. Argentina's government has joined his fight to prove he was a victim of anti-Semitic discrimination during the military dictatorship. Eduardo Sayé remembers very well the day police stormed his office in Buenos Aires back in 1980. He was taken to this building right next to the presidential palace to be tortured and encouraged to sign away the rights to his Banco Latinoamericano, one of Argentina's major banks. Eventually, he did.
They tortured me by pushing my head underwater so I couldn't breathe. The terror lasted 7 days. They wanted me to confess to crimes I didn't commit so they could force me to hand over my bank.
Sayé never confessed, but negotiated a $500,000 ransom to save his life. As part of the deal, he gave away his bank and shares of the airline company Austral.
They robbed my bank so they could steal the airline company.
Sayé wasn't the only businessman persecuted by the military who ruled Argentina from 1976 to 1983. But he was one of the few who stayed in the country after being robbed. Instead of fleeing, the banker decided to gather piles of evidence against the civilians behind the crimes.
This is something few people know abroad. They know there was a military coup and that 30,000 people disappeared. They don't know that the military were acting on behalf of civilians who wanted to protect their economic interests. Among them, former finance minister Martínez de Hoz and central bank head Alejandro Reynal.
Over the past three decades, Sayé has made his case in the press, in a book, in a personal blog, and in court. Now he's no longer alone. Argentina's government joined his fight to convict Martínez de Hoz and Reynal. Argentina is still trying the military responsible for human rights violations during the dictatorship. Now the government is turning its attention to the economic crimes and to the civilians who either masterminded or benefited from them. Maria Celeste Personino works in a special division investigating such crimes.
We noticed that by 1978, the military had already quashed the guerrilla movements and started moving against what they call economic subversion. They repressed business groups for economic or political reasons.
Sayé, like many in the Jewish community, accused the military regime of anti-Semitic policies. They believe the plan was to oust Jews from Argentina's major banks.
In 1999, Spanish judge Baltasar Garzón examined her testimonies and evidence and concluded that Jews were persecuted during the Argentine military regime. I'm not saying that. Had I not been a Jew, I would not have been tortured. But it would not have been so violent.
Sayé is now waiting for the Argentine court to try his case. He says all he wants is justice and the assurance that nobody, including members of the Argentine Jewish community, will ever have to fear persecution again. Monica Yanakiev for JN1 in Buenos Aires.